If you, as an electrician, engineer, or control panel enthusiast, have been looking everywhere to level up your electrical control panel wiring skills and want to see the process from start to finish building a panel, then get your tools ready because in 9 minutes, actually it's 9 minutes, 11 seconds, I hope that's not a deal breaker, I'm gonna take you on a journey turning this blank, useless, unhelpful metal canvas into this completed, fully functional, good-looking work of art. If I do say so myself. Okay guys, so I'm watching this on my iPad and I'm gonna be talking you through what I'm doing as the video progresses. Okay, yeah, so here you can just see getting things unpacked and then starting to mark out the lining or the lines for the trunking and the DIN rail. And then I'm just measuring up the trunking here, just getting it to the right length. Getting the holes marked onto the back plate of the panel, cutting them to length. And then what I do here is I label whether it's D for DIN rail or T for trunking. And it just sort of makes it easier to, when you've got them all cut to length, to line them up where they should be. And again, you can see here, I've just marked the holes for the drill and I've just center tapped them. Now I'm going straight in with tech screws. Some people might disagree with me on that one, but it's far quicker just to go straight in with tech screws rather than doing like a drilled hole and a tapped hole. Just double checking my layout. Just snap the finger trunking, really satisfying that is. Now, weirdly, this is one of my favorite parts, just getting all the components onto the panel to match the layout drawing that I created. I don't know what it is, just I really like that. Before any of the wiring goes in, it's just nice to see all the components there ready to be wired. Up to the loft again to get components. You see there, I was just marking out the holes for the earth bar. Drilling the holes there. I forgot about it when I was drilling the back plate earlier for the DIN rail and trunking. Forgot to do the earth bar. Yeah, also same thing for the contactors with overloads. So I didn't put those onto a bit of DIN rail. As you can see, they're slightly offset or they wouldn't have been aligned with the rest of the components on that DIN rail. So they're drilled and tapped or tech screwed separately as well. And here I'm just getting the distribution circuit terminal blocks and just labeling everything ready to start wiring. I always start off with the main supplies, so you can see the thicker cores of the of the sorry, got distracted, of the neutral and live there. And then next thing I do is I put in the KNX cable, so that green cable that sort of buses along to all the components. Then doing all the neutrals. And then doing, I think, one out of the other side of one of the MCBs to start feeding. I think these were the relay feeds, the live feeds to the relays. As you can see there, I'm coming off that distribution block in the sort of middle left. So yeah, I focus on the main side first and then move on to the extra low voltage, which is what we're doing now. So
those white cables, therefore either digital inputs coming from relays or contactors to tell our PLC or KNX electronics in this case that something's happened out in the field. So if a relay energizes or a contact energizes, we then know that through the electronics. Those orange cables, they're accepted circuits. So say, for example, we isolated the panel, we might still have voltage coming in from a separate source outside of the panel that could potentially be live. So all those cables are in orange. The red cables, they're 24 volts DC. And now we're on to just marking out the front panel door. It's not too much going on this one. Really like this panel actually. It was a budget BMS panel, so it didn't have all the cam switch and indicator lights. But yeah, it was for HVAC control within a plant room. Yeah, and you can see here using the laser method to mark the center of the shaft for the isolator, the door isolator. Always a bit of a squeaky bum moment doing that. Giving it a deburr. Getting that mounting plate nicely square before fitting the touchscreen. Now those holes were properly drilled and tapped. No tech screws used there. And there was actually quite a few modifications to this panel. Things changed on site, so yeah, I went back and had to modify things a few times on this before it actually went out to site. Guys, if you found this video helpful, really appreciate a like. It would help the YouTube algorithm then feed this video to potentially other people similar to you looking to learn a bit about control panels. Yeah, and here you can see I'm just adding the cables to the doors. So yeah, that'd be power and communication going to the touchscreen, and I can't remember what that light was doing on the front actually. It was either a general fault light or it was a control circuit good light. So that's the 24 volts of the touchscreen there, that red and black cable. Oh yeah, guys, if you want to learn a bit more about electrical schematics, there's a link in my description that will talk you through all of that. Finishing off that earth to the door. And within the panel as well, bottom left hand corner of the panel. I'm getting the trunking lids cut. Get quite particular about this. I want to make sure they're like absolutely perfect, and especially the horizontal ones. I want to make sure that they butt up nice and tight, but without warping things to the vertical ones. Now this panel was controlling all the HVAC within a plant room for a high-end residential property in London using KNX. And if you'd like to see something similar, but for a much smaller project using LOXON, then why don't you check out this video here where I break down the steps into much smaller details.